Porto 3, Manchester United 3, and the United Twins need to speak about it. United, United. Blessings to everybody inside, including yourself, Cappy. My goodness, away from home. It was always going to be a difficult game when you factor in the team we're speaking about with the atmosphere. Also, despite all of that, it was actually a decent start to the game. United took advantage of opportunities to create in transition and scored twice. First from Marcus Rashford, received the ball from Eriksen, was direct, drove towards the area and instinctively got past two Porto defenders with a right to left before striking near post. Beat Diogo Costa as the ball just squirmed under him. Something similar also happened with Rasmus Højlund's goal after 20 minutes as, again, on the break, Eriksen to Rashford, but this time Marcus turned provider. Rasmus times the run in behind perfectly and uses power to beat the right hand of Costa, who looked to be caught off guard. He could only watch as United's second goal just bounced across the line. Only just two fortuitous goals, you could say, but on face value, it's quite an ideal position to be in away from home in Europe. That's as long as you can manage the game in a manner which creates and maintains calmness all round. And of course that wasn't the case. Porto, credit to them, didn't look as phased after conceding two goals in such a manner. They dusted off their shoulders, grew into the game even more and continued to create or at least look dangerous in our final third. One player who stood out in the early stages was Samu. On the night was an absolute handful for both centre-backs, De Ligt and Lisandro Martinez, struggled. Anybody who defended against him, honestly, and his two goals, one to equalise and the other to give them a 3-2 lead in the second half, epitomised the level of confidence he was playing with. Perhaps the entire team also, because they essentially got back into the game in the space of 4 minutes. First from Pepe and then Samu. The clear theme was deliveries into the area from or close to our left side. João Mario gets the ball in for their first, as Onana saves the initial header, which I think came off Mashraoui, I think so. It's an easy follow-up for Pepe, who reacted much quicker than Lisandro. Yudica was just simply too casual, ball-watching instead of being aware of the danger. The second was a little more messier during their build-up, but found its way to that man again, João Mario, who delicately lifted the ball towards Samu, who devoured. Crushing header past Andre Onana. More drama for Manchester United. And it goes to show there's no such thing as control when you're dealing with a side so comfortable in being engaged in a blow-for-blow affair. Here's the thing, you guys, and this is nothing brand new, but it's so alarming. Seeing how unoccupied our midfield was at times again. Wait. We provided them with acres of space to operate in, giving away possession cheaply. It's the same old story. Like a DJ that's wheeling up a dead tune time and time again, just reading the room, not sir. One stat that I heard over commentary was the fact that no other Premier League side, I believe, has conceded 3 goals in all competitions more than Manchester United since Erik ten Hag's arrival. 24 times and counting, because it may not be the last. All Aston Villa coming up on the weekend. They are coming off an exhilarating victory against Bayern Munich at Villa Park, and those results can either pick you up, keep the momentum rolling, or make a side come into their next fixture a little flat because of the nature of their previous result. So it will be interesting to see what happens on Sunday at their home ground. Luckily enough for us tonight, we just about salvaged the point with Harry Maguire coming off the bench to equalise from a corner kick with delivery by Christian Eriksen as Maguire confidently headed the ball into the ground and past Diogo Costa, who didn't have the greatest of nights himself. He could do nothing about that finish, however. And I heard people say that perhaps the goal or that goal will change the perception of things, but for me, it totally didn't. Lose or draw, my opinion on the game, how it flowed, how everything fell apart, once again for Manchester United would have remained the same regardless. And for me, once again, that's the only way you get to regulate a sensible opinion, by understanding that the only constant with United is their lack of consistency, not just on a game-to-game basis, but throughout a 90-minute fixture. Honestly speaking, that game, I feel, could have been dead and buried if Porto finished at least one of their second half opportunities that they had while looking to already protect their 3-2 lead. It didn't happen for them, and eventually our sustained pressure for the last 20 to 25 minutes paid off. Despite my brief celebrations, at full time I just went straight to my computer because I was over it. Maybe that is the mindset we all have to adopt. With all the madness surrounding us at this current moment of time, should we be more patient? Now, I can make arguments for both sides, but my feeling right now is that I'm tired. Watching most United games can be strenuous for one's brain, creating unhealthy overload. Erik ten Hag is speaking about being in a process or the process. I can accept that with genuine change and initial growing pains need to occur, which often begins with regression before progression. Maybe more clarity is needed when it comes to the process and what that may entail considering the landscape we live in today. Let us know in the comment section how you're currently feeling about Manchester United's process to eventual success. That is the aim, right? And make sure you're hitting that like button if you've reached this part of the video, subscribing if you're new, sharing to your friends and frenemies. And until the next time, Vitter on Sunday. Watch out for our vibe check. Should be out on Saturday. We'll see you not in a bit. Bedtime.